in on some peanut history. It's actually National Peanut Day, and we have our real nut for history here with us today. He's giving us some great and fun facts about this versatile food. We have Raffi Andonian here with us, our celebrity historian. Thanks for joining me.
Of course. You know what time that means it is, with the cracking nuts you're talking about. Peanut butter jelly time.
Peanut butter jelly time.
Peanut butter jelly time.
We didn't plan that, I hope y'all know. Raffi, thank you so much for bringing your energy. And this actually has a kind of cool Missouri tie to it.
It does. Now, well, part of it is a myth, part of it is real.
Okay. So
we have this story that, you know, peanut butter started in St. Louis, or at least popularized in St. Louis, but it's not quite true.
Ooh.
Peanuts start with the, and mashing of peanuts start with the Inca down in South America, move over with European traders later to Africa and Asia, and then with Africans and Europeans coming back across the Atlantic, comes to North America. That's when it comes to North America. More recently, we're talking about the 18th century. Now, in the 18th century, you know what also happened? There's an era of the founding fathers. Here, have the spoon.
Okay.
That's peanut soup. This is one of the favorites.
Soup.
One of the favorites of the founding fathers.
Okay.
You can actually, we have the recipe on that on a food blog called noshingswithnicole.com. That's where you can get that. The colonial founding fathers loved it. Yeah, I just heated it up too.
Gosh.
Yeah, the colonial recipe is what we're using now. What's fascinating from there is I've had it already, so you can keep eating it.
I'm just going to put it back in there. It was really good, though.
But that tells you that the mashing of peanuts, whether in soup or kind of buttery form, goes back hundreds of years, long before the way we think of peanut butter.
I know. Okay, now who knew? I mean, where does peanut butter come into the picture then?
Well, what happens the way we think about it is, first, peanuts had to get popularized in the 19th century. So there's a couple reasons for that. P.T. Barnum, the circus guy, that's part of the reason you have peanuts at the ball game. You have peanuts at the circus. He kind of popularized it at special events. Then you have George Washington Carter, from right here in Missouri, although he's teaching down in Alabama at Tuskegee, but he's from right here in Missouri. He goes promoting many uses of peanuts. One of the ways he promotes it, let's check it out. The peanut butter is one of them.
Okay.
Is to actually shave with it.
What?
So you know what? Let's test it out.
Oh,
let's
my
see
gosh.
If we can.
This is amazing.
See?
You've made my day. I hope
see
you
right
know.
There.
Okay.
And what's fascinating about that, is as he does that, John Harvey Kellogg gets in the mix. 1895, he invents a form of peanut butter. Now let's see if this works.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. See,
it does work.
Right there.
And I'm sure it doesn't cause
nice
those yucky razor bumps.
Yep, exactly. Look at that. That's cleaner there than it is elsewhere.
Okay, we got peanut soup. We're shaving with peanut butter.
Now, what's important about Kellogg, the cereal guy, right? He promotes it as a health food.
Okay.
Promotes it as, because it's...
It does keep you full.
That's right. It has protein. It has no animal fat. Mm-hmm. It's plant-based. It's in Housewife magazines to influence them. And it gets celebrity endorsement behind it.
Oh, my gosh.
People like Amelia Earhart and of course, Henry Ford. Mm-hmm. Celebrity endorsement is being used 100 years ago to promote peanut butter. Now, the St. Louis tie is then the technology comes around because you have the technology to go ahead and make peanut shelling faster, make it cleaner and easier so you could distribute it. Partial hydrogenation so you get the consistency that you get, so it's shell stable. And finally, sliced bread. Sliced bread is invented in Iowa, but the first baker to buy it was in Chillicothe, Missouri. Second baker was right here in St. Louis.
Gustav
Papendick, that's right. And the reason that matters is because he improves on the sliced bread. And when the sliced bread gets popular, that's when peanut butter and jelly can take off, and that's right here in St. Louis.
Peanut
that's how we help it out.
Time.
Peanut butter jelly time. Exactly.
I love
exactly.
that.
So it's a combination of all those historic figures, George Washington Carver, John Harvey Kellogg, the endorsements we talked about, and right here, the baker doing that in the 1920s.
That is amazing. All right here in the Show Me State. Now, this is pretty amazing. Okay, Raffi, celebrating National Peanut Day. Before I let you go.
Finish.
I know, you got to do the other side. We got to have balance here on Studio STL. Do you like crunchy peanut butter or smooth peanut butter?
I like it crunchy.
Me too. I love crunchy peanut butter. Now, do you like it with jelly?
I love the jelly on there.
Grape
the contrast,
jelly?
The contrast. Grape or strawberry?
Grape
yeah, the contrast of the sweet and the, you know,
it's so
but
good.
I like more peanut butter on it than jelly. You see what
you
I'm
get
saying?
Me. You
now,
get me.
A funny story about that real quick is there was a Nicaraguan-born journalist a few years ago on NPR, and someone asked him, what made you feel like you were finally American? Because he was, you know, becoming a citizen. He said, when I discovered I love peanut butter.
Oh, my gosh. Well, there we go. It is the true American treat with a lot of Missouri ties. And if you want to learn more about some history, not only here in St. Louis, but really across Missouri and really the world, you can follow the celebrity historian online on YouTube and on Instagram and visit him on his website, celebrityhistorian.com. Happy National Peanut Day.